Hey everybody out of Azusa Pacific University, this is Ed, your street art journalist correspondent. We're standing next to Homage the Black Lorette. We're calling it Lorette Pack. It's by a young artist called Melk the Bunny, but this is part of what I do. I go out in the street, dodge cars, wave at them. How you doing? Hey, Jerry. And then we find out what to report. Later, if I decide to, I could do a whole critique. But that sort of becomes a dividing line of what's art's reporting and what's art critique. We'll explain more on this videotape we're going on now.
Flat, if you please. Flash, scoop, scoop. I came over the River Jordan from a weekly scandal sheet and asked old John Garrison for a job. Are you a journalist or a reporter? He said. What's the difference? I said. A journalist makes himself the hero of the story. A reporter is only the witness.
That's Jim Backus. He plays a reporter at Deadline USA, a 1952 film about newspapers that starred Humphrey Bogart as editor Ed Hutchinson. The quote helps us understand how being arts reporter is one way to develop into a star art critic essayist. In the quote, the word critic could take the place of the word journalist. Words driven by personality and ideas, such as contemporary art, can shift a writer from witness to participant. That's not a negative comment to what a critic does. We all wish there was more judgment and criticism. Rather, repurposing the quote from Deadline USA clarifies how reporting is about being the witness. It's also important because objective observation feeds a subjective reader and author. A good report gives details for an art critic to respond to and gives ways for a reader to understand a subject or event. Reporting basics start by being an accurate storyteller and gathers the who, what, why, and where. A pithy introduction becomes a strong lead and can guide a reader through an arts-based story that can be a preview or a short profile about an artist. A reporter's duty is not to pass judgment, even if you quote the judgment of others. From another angle, that's the same idea behind Edmund Feldman, who says that descriptive words should be neutral. Yet, you're not really hiding an opinion because selecting stories to write about is curating your time and resources. Consider when we read criticism, we depend on that objective information to be a springboard for our thought. If you gather facts with strong reporting skills, you can give your writing more credibility, and your passion has a stronger starting point. So that's one way reporting is a way for thoughtful criticism to start. Your notes become valuable support to your developing critical eye that will tell a reader why you don't like or love a piece of art, or explain what kind of emotions you connect to the work. News about art is also about making the subject accessible to a larger audience. It's rewarding to write to us readership of scholars, art historians, and collectors, yet it's also important to communicate the ideas and processes to a broader audience. That's how a reporter can influence what others think about art. If done well, it increases patronage. And if the art is deemed important, as in the case of murals that came out of Los Angeles during the 1970s and 80s, those patrons may become guardians of those works. In 2011, when living in Los Angeles, I saw a guerrilla street sign on Winston Street. I recognized the style of artist from a previous installation. That's sort of the who. But I looked into why it was there. It became a short post, and the where became part of the story, since it was about reclaiming buried history off Winston, in a small alley that was called Indian Alley. What they did helped raise awareness of the site. Since then, the walls have filled up with work from other street artists, and there's been additional coverage. and sometimes what is witnessed is an honest document of a moment. The most powerful prose in Los Angeles art history was the audience responding to the unveiling of David Alfaro Siqueiro's America Tropical in 1932. The dedication revealed an indigenous figure on a crucifix that was painted under wraps in the night and wasn't what was expected for the commission that was to enhance the commercial space of Avera Street. That gas has been recanted in academic journals and articles and is a benchmark in Los Angeles arts history and maybe in a national legacy of murals. The critic's most quoted part of that article came from his reporting narrative. And just as there's overlap between graffiti and street art, there's overlap in arts reporting and the interpretation of art as a decoding of supposed meaning. But then again, we have to go back to old school lessons on reporting. Now, taking mental notes if you see interesting art piece in a local coffee house, that's an instinct at work. Trust it. Know which hat to wear. Do you want to be an art critic who can dismiss a painting seen in a retail environment? That's an option. Or do you want to be a curious arts reporter willing to ask the who, what, why, and where? Why did the coffee house owner put something up? Who is the artist? Then you can switch narrative a bit and put the critic hat back on and start writing what the work is about or how it works in a non-traditional space. And you, even as a student of arts criticism, can take one piece of art that looks out of place in a coffee house and tell us why it deserves more. You are lifting the value to that piece, even with simple documentation or commentary, because it got your attention as a member of that community. Arts criticism is needed to add context to an art community. Arts reporting can help us understand why art belongs in the community at large. I'll be curious. Get out there. Art is your beat.